Hi, my name is Shannon Gunn and I'm from Washington, D.C. And this video is about how to cut down on the reaction time for the metronome. So basically the problem is that sometimes when you record MIDI, you have this situation where you press down a key and you hear, you know, a delay in the sound. Well, that's latency, and you can fix that by just, you know, decreasing the buffer size or decreasing the sample rate. But there's another issue that often shows up in MIDI when you record, and that is you're pressing the key down at the exact same time as the metronome, but you're still considered, like when you listen back, it's still behind the metronome. And what's happening behind the scenes is that the metronome click is taking too long for the computer to process. It's like such a simple concept, but it causes so much problems when you're, you know, recording into MIDI. So what I've discovered is some of these programs, such as Mixcraft, have a wave file as the metronome tick sound instead of an MP3 file. And just those extra 26 megabytes, even though the file is like really tiny because it's just a small little like snare drum hit or something, even though the file is really short and really small, just that amount of information between like a little MP3 of it versus a wave of that particular tick sound can cause delay from the time that the computer generates the tick sound to the time that you hear it. So you could be playing right on time with the tick sound, but because you're hearing it like a half a second after it's being generated by the computer thinks you're a half second off, and it records you a half second behind. And so everything's consistently behind, but it's hard to mess with that in quantization as a result. So you can always change the sound of the tick, but sometimes it's hard to know how to do that. So this tutorial is how to change the tick sound from a wave file to an MP3 file in a digital audio workstation called Mixcraft. And even if you don't have Mixcraft, maybe this will help you with recording MIDI in the future. Okay, good luck, and thanks for watching.